news story we've been following this morning. Emergency crews are on the scene of a train derailment in southwestern Jefferson County.
It happened just after 6 a.m. at Katherine Station Road at Dixie Highway. WLKY's Eric King joins us live from the scene with the very latest. Eric, what can you tell us?
Well, I can tell you this got a lot bigger than we initially expected. We were initially told that 5 cars had overturned. That number has now increased to 30. Let me step out of the way and kind of show you the Metro emergency response team. We were just briefed by them. What I can tell you is shortly before 6 a.m. this morning, about 30 train cars derailed. One of those cars was carrying a chemical called butadiene. That's an inhalation hazard. It is in liquid form, but when it comes out, it also becomes gassy. There's a slight sulfurous smell to it. As a result, they have activated a hazmat level 3. That's the highest level of hazmat that they can offer. As part of that, they've evacuated an area down here referred to as Abbott Beach. That's the extent of the evacuation right now. Just to give you a perspective on the size of this, a level 3 hazmat is an incident involving the release of substantial quantities of hazardous materials posing significant risk to public health and environment, requiring major response and logistical support operations, large-scale precautionary evacuations, and establishment of temporary shelter sites may be required. Again, we were just briefed by the head of MetroSafe, Doug Hamilton, and he's relaying that information to us. What they're doing right now, they're sending in a recon team. They're also monitoring the air quality. There have been no injuries as of right now, but the road has been closed. Dixie Highway, if we can kind of, Patrick, just kind of spin you around this way. Traffic is being blocked off on Dixie Highway. It is closed from the southern part of Dixie Highway all the way down to the county line. No injuries have been reported in this. That's a good thing as of right now. Since we're talking about air quality, obviously the potential threat, they're keeping us about 2 miles away. So that's why you're not able to see any of the cars. We're sending up the WLKY news chopper to try to get a better handle on this. But as it stands right now, if you're familiar with the chemical butadiene, that is an inhalation hazard. It comes out in liquid form, then becomes gaseous. They're sending in a recon team to find out the extent of this, but they've declared a level 3 hazmat just to make sure all precautions are in place. Kind of an all hands on deck kind of situation. They've got PRP, fire department here. They've got the entire Metro emergency response team. As more information becomes available, we'll certainly jump in and pass it on to you. But as it stands right now, there is a threat in the air as far as the gaseous nature of this chemical. We're right next to the Ohio River, so that obviously is a big concern too, as well as the Salt River. There are questions on the table whether or not this chemical leaked into the Salt River or the Ohio River. Those questions are not answerable at this point. So they're working on that. As soon as they pass that along to us, we'll pass it on to you because we recognize this is an issue of public safety at this point, and there's a lot of information that needs to be relayed to you. Mm-hmm. With that, Monica, Natasha, that's the extent of what I know. If I missed anything, feel free to ask me, but I'll go ahead and send it back to you.
Sounds as though you've got it covered, Eric. As soon as you get those bits of information that we can pass along for the safety of residents in that area, certainly looking forward to that information. Mm-hmm. Eric King reporting live. Thank you.